Bro, you in class you read trigonometry, yeah?
Yeah, bro, it was pretty interesting. Why?
I mean, like, in my class we started last week, so it's pretty confusing.
I mean, I think if you understand where it came from, it might be more interesting. Just try it out.
I mean, I know it came from India, but like, I think I can find out more about it.
I'm telling you, it will be much, much, much more interesting.
Trigonometry, a topic that we all have or will learn in school. Some people dread it and some people love it. But it actually gets more use than you think.
In fact, it's been used for hundreds of years. But first, let's find a tiny bit about it.
Before that, we make interesting videos on topics just like this one. So if you like our content, don't forget to subscribe. Now, back to the video. Trigonometry is a field of mathematics that studies relationships between the side lengths and angles of triangles.
Now, we won't teach you all about it, but the only important thing is that there are six main trigonometric functions, which we will come to in a bit.
To really understand where trigonometry actually came from in India, we need to go back around the 5th century. You know, when India was ruled by the Gupta Empire and some people invaded us from the north? Just 5th century AD things.
So in the 5th century, there was a set of influential works that were written called the Siddhantas. Now, there were 5 of them. You don't need to know about them. There's only one that you need to know about. The Surya Siddhanta.
Remember we said that there are 6 trigonometric functions? The Surya Siddhanta defines 2 of them, sine and cosine.
Now, don't worry too much on what they mean, because for the context of this video, it's not really important. Now, finally, we're gonna talk about him. The man, the myth, the legend, Aryabhatta.
Aryabhatta was one of India's most renowned mathematician and astronomer. Now, most of us know him just for the zero, but he had a pretty big part to play in trigonometry.
What Aryabhatta did is what scientists even today do all the time. They build on what others do. Aryabhatta built on the Surya Siddhanta and developed some concepts further in his book, The Aryabhatiya.
The Aryabhatiya has a lot of interesting things related to astronomy, but it also contains the earliest surviving tables of sine values.
Both the Surya Siddhanta and the Aryabhatiya use the words jya for sine and kojya for cosine, which were lost in translation to become sine and cosine.
A lot of other Indian mathematicians worked on trigonometry. Bhaskara 1 and Bhaskara 2 came up with many developments in this field, one of which was calculating the sine value of acute angles.
Madhva, who was another mathematician of the time, made great strides in analysis of trigonometric functions.
So how exactly is this video gonna help me for my exam tomorrow morning?
Yeah, about that, this isn't exactly the video for you. You should have just paid attention in class.
Dang it.
So wait, trigonometry was not first used in India. It was first found out in ancient Egypt, where there are paintings in the pyramid walls that clearly show studies about triangles.
When we go broader, trigonometry is a concept that astronomers and mathematicians from all around the world contributed to. Many from the Middle East, where the text was translated into Arabic and Greek, contributed to the field of trigonometry.
Let's go into a major application of this concept. Cartographers are people who make maps.
Only was it in the 16th century that the cartographers were able to use the trigonometric calculations to come up with a fairly decent world map.
Spoiled generation, oh my god.
Trigonometry can help in calculating sea level. And with that, along with other more complex calculations, maps were made.
In India, buildings were constructed using trigonometry. The Taj Mahal architects used trigonometry to find a safe height for the main dome.
Something that we realized while making this video is that a topic could be so boring and unappealing, especially when taught from a textbook. But just looking back in time and understanding how it's really used just makes it so much more fun to learn.
Maybe one day these concepts might have a new twist to them. Maybe our generation will be able to make greater strides in them. The possibilities are endless.
But until that day comes, pay attention in class. Especially you, Yashodhara, what are you doing? Unbelievable.
Okay, dude, I guess.